Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straight Smile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today I promised one of my followers I was going to talk about a Bristolian maxillary intrusion arch. And I occasionally take requests, even if it's not something I want to talk about, or if I think it's something that's a little outdated or obsolete. The point of my channel is to have easy, reliable, predictable, healthy, airway-friendly biomechanics for orthodontists. Sorry, not for orthodontists, for general and pediatric dentists wanting to learn ortho. Of course, I get a lot of orthodontists who are on my channel from other countries who want to learn stuff, and I respect that. That's pretty cool. So I do take a request occasionally, and I don't do surgical stuff. So this kind of fits the mold. Bristolian maxillary intrusion arch is very circa 50 years ago, 40 years ago, 30 years ago. People don't really do these in the United States anymore, but it's not that they don't work. It's just they don't fly, meaning that these parents are going to complain. These kids are going to complain. It's not going to happen in the United States. So sorry that this is black and white, but I had to pay a graphic artist to make this because I didn't have an example that I could show, because the last one I did was probably 2002. So, and I did plenty of them back then. So I had to have it sketched. So, and I didn't feel like paying an extra $50 to have colors put into it. So basically this is unactivated and this is activated, okay? You can buy these. We used to bend them out of TMA wire ourselves. Big pain in the butt. But you can buy them pre-made in Nitai. Maybe it was Ortho Arch. You're gonna have to Google Nitai maxillary intrusion arch and scroll through. I definitely found one. They had it in two sizes. There was like a 1622 and a 1725. I would take the 1725. Basically, there's gonna be a base wire, which is gonna be your regular Nitai, be it your 12 or your 14 or your 16 or your 18 Nitai, whatever's the biggest possible wire you can fully get into the slot and fully engage. I would personally use steel ties to tie this in. 1, 2, 3, 4. They used O ties in the photo, but I would use steel ties to tie it in. That way you don't have to worry about changing colors each time, because to be honest, once you activate this, you're gonna wanna leave it for 4 months, 5 months, 6 months. And if you have colors on it, then it's gonna be a pain. You can put the brackets on the back teeth, but they're serving no function. So my suggestion is don't put colors on, because then you're gonna have to change it. And once you activate it, it's gonna get in the way of being able to change it. So use your steel ties here on your Nitai. Make sure you cinch back your Nitai on each side. I didn't really illustrate that there. And then you're going to put it in the slot. I like the idea of putting the bumper tissue guard here because it keeps it from cutting in the cheek. And you're going to go ahead and just pull this down like a lever or a lever. And then once it's down, you're going to take three steel ties between 1, 2, 3. Twist, 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 twist. Of course, like anytime you have a steel tie or a long tie, you're going to have a little pigtail at the end. I like the idea of putting a little tiny blob of composite on the ends. That way it's not uncomfortable. You don't have to worry about it flipping around and cutting the patient, which is kind of what happens. And then that's it. So basically it's absolute intrusion from 2 to 2, 7 to 10 of just here. This is just the moment in the back, you know. And that's about it. That is what it does. It does work. If you have a case that needs absolute intrusion of incisors and doesn't need any relative extrusion of molars and premolars, then this is a way to do it. You can buy these. If you can find a patient that's not going to complain about it, great. You know, occasionally you'll find somebody. The suckers do work. So, if you have any other questions besides what I said right now, sorry, I'm not the right person, because like I said, it's been 20 something years since I've done one. I know I had this all memorized, and you can see what came back still. I was taught by Charlie Burstone himself in person. So great guy. So I want to leave his legacy, and this is my gift to his legacy. This is probably my favorite thing that I believe he developed this, or at least I thought we were told he did. So this is probably my favorite appliance that he taught us, the one that I would still potentially use now. I know, but I would in the right case if there was nothing else available. But, you know, patients are going to complain. So anyways, anything else you want, you got to get a book. All right. So I'm not going to be answering any questions on this. All right. Thanks.